Hi there, welcome to my lab 9. So I'm gonna introduce this problem. We have a, I play in a group of about 8 to 10 guys and we play poker. So there's usually one or two dealers, but one of our group mates is actually a deck massager. He has a habit where he moves the cards around after they're already shuffled and it makes everybody annoyed and then nobody else wants to deal besides this one guy. So that leads to poker beef. Here are my drawings. I gave a name, dealer-o-matic 9000. This is all drafted in centimeters, with the top view in the top left, 3D view in the top right, and then the front view in the bottom left with a detail in the center. And here's another photo of my drafting. You may see at the bottom, it's for Sal Icolina. I don't have the machinery in College Park to mill this effectively, so my grandfather actually is a talented machinist. He used to make props for the advertisement industry in New York City. He used his machines to make this for me. Here's the solution. Most of my work in this project, well, this is a mechatronics class. This project really is the mech in mechatronics. You can see right here, it's a slit. It's where the cards come out. Right here is the casing. This is a card bed. And then under is a shelf for the servo to sit on and the wires to pass through. The circuit is pretty simple. It's all 5-volt source, ground. There's a potentiometer that's gonna control the threshold for if the wheel is spinning or not. A 1 kilo-ohm resistor for safety, and then analog output to back to the Arduino. Here's my Arduino code. We got the servo library involved. I named my servo SAC, no particular reason. We have our serial.begin, and then SAC attach in the servo library, pretty much you attach a given servo to a given pin, which for me is 9. And then I denoted Z as the analog read value. And I used a while loop. As long as the clock is on, I want this thing working. And that was the theory behind this. So the brakes tended to work. I had a lot of trouble early with getting this. It was actually a continuous rotating servo. So instead of angles for, servo right, you'd have to use a given integer value to denote a speed. So 90 is not even a speed at all. It's actually not moving at all. While 300... and I made it negative for my given direction, which you will see very soon. And that's the Arduino. So for the processing, we run it. And this is more of an indicator for testing, to show what the threshold for when the wheel is moving or not moving. As you can see, the maximum of the threshold, it's a little bit shaky as you're going up. So a safe bet is to be both either below the threshold min or above the threshold max. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough for counting. When the dealing's done, you got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be